Okay, students, so this is isolation of genomic DNA from bacterial cells. It is to extract DNA from bacterial cells, that is Escherichia coli, and the principle of this experiment is the genetic material or the genome in bacteria is not very well organized as compared to that of the eukaryotic genome, which is highly condensed and are present as nucleosomes. So extraction of bacterial genomic DNA is a fairly simple process and do not involve elaborate protocols. There are three major types of techniques. A combination of these three techniques are employed in the isolation of nucleic acids: differential solubility, adsorption methods, density gradient centrifugation. The major goal of nucleic acid isolation is removal of proteins, which is accomplished due to their different chemical properties. Most of the nucleic acid isolation protocols involve cell lysis step, enzymatic treatments, differential solubility by either phenol extraction or adsorption procedure or through a solid support, and then precipitation. Now, for cell lysis, the first step, nucleic acid, the DNA or RNA must be solubilized from the cells or other biological material. This solubilization usually is carried out under denatural conditions such as SDS, alkali, boiling, or using of chemotrophic agents like guanidium thiocyanate. These denatural conditions efficiently solubilize the nucleic acids and generally do not adversely affect them. In addition, the denatural conditions promote the removal of proteins during the subsequent steps and inhibit the activity of nucleases that will degrade the nucleic acids. Enzymatic treatment. Unwanted components like proteins and RNA are degraded by enzymes generally included in the lysis buffer. One enzyme is the protease enzyme, specifically proteinase K. They use to remove the proteins, and RNase, that is RNase A, to break the RNA. Third step is differential solubility, that is mainly phenol extraction. Phenol is an organic solvent which is used to separate the proteins from DNA. It is mixed in equal volumes with the DNA. The two phases are then separated by centrifugation, and the upper aqueous phase that contains the nucleic acid alone is retained. Proteins are seen as flocculent material at their interface. Precipitation. DNA is precipitated from dilute solutions either with ethanol or with isopropanol in presence of sodium or potassium acetate with a pH ranging from 5 to 5.5, which is added to a final concentration of 0.3 molar. Sodium and acidic pH will neutralize the highly charged phosphate backbone and promotes hydrophobic interactions. The precipitated DNA is collected by centrifugation, or it is pulled out with a pasture filter. The pellet is rinsed with 70% ethanol to remove any excess amount of salt. Then it can be dried and it can be dissolved in an appropriate buffer. Requirements: bacterial cells, lysis solution, 70% alcohol, ethanol. Centrifuge 1.5 ml of 24 hours bacterial culture at 6000 rpm at 4 degrees centigrade for 8 minutes to get the bacterial pellet. Remove the culture supernatant carefully and discard it. Resuspend the cells in 700 microliter of solution A at room temperature. Incubate at room temperature for 5 minutes and spin at 10,000 rpm for 10 minutes. Now collect the 500 microliter of again that supernatant into a fresh vial and avoid taking the pellet. Add 1 ml of alcohol to 500 microliter of the supernatant what you have transferred now. Mix it gently by inverting the tube until white strands of DNA are precipitated out are being visible to you. Spool the precipitated DNA with the help of a tip and transfer it into a fresh vial. The obtained genomic DNA can be subjected to agarose gel electrophoresis along with the DNA ladder, and the separated DNA fragments can be further analyzed.